He was aboard the USS Vinson, the ship that carried out the top secret plan to bury Usama bin Laden at sea. They weighted him down and dropped him overboard. Master Chief Bill Houlihan, finally home after an eventful 7-month deployment. Thank you so much, Master Chief, for your service. Good to have you home. You came home on June 15th. What was it like pulling into San Diego?
Hey, good morning, Brian. Thanks for having me on this morning. It was great. Every time you come back from deployment, it's a fantastic event. So this one was no more special, but definitely just as great as the rest of them.
Well, I can imagine when you come back home, you have to sit there at attention as you pull up to port. Is it tough looking down, seeing your family you haven't seen in 7 months, in some cases children you haven't met yet, and then staying at attention?
It's parade rest usually for most of it, but it's about an hour that we man the rail, so that's a long trip, and especially when you know that you've got family members on the pier that you've been waiting to see for a long time. So it's pretty fun, but it's challenging.
So Master Chief, the USS Vinson for 7 months had a lot of operations. Every day was a work day, but most people are going to remember, and history will chronicle, the fact that it was your ship where bin Laden's body was brought to, was dressed, we understand, and then was ceremoniously tossed overboard. What could you tell us about that night? What did you know?
I can tell you absolutely nothing about that night. That's just a subject that we as a crew are not going to discuss. Our captain has made it very clear to us that that's just the details are not ours to give. And so that's just a subject we're typically and commonly not going to talk about.
Could you tell me, did you know that he was on board, that there was something going on? Or did you just say, oh, I guess we're just tossing some carp overboard?
Honestly, we just had no clue. And because of that, that's a reason. You know, we stay in our lane. That's what we're going to do. Those of us who don't know anything about any event are not going to talk about it. And I think that's a safe way to do business.
Right. And how did you eventually find out?
I found out about the fact that Osama bin Laden was killed over the news.
And what were your thoughts?
You know, a large portion of our crew joined the Navy after 9/11, and I think that goes for a large portion of the military. So what that means to me is that a lot of these sailors and soldiers and Marines and airmen, they joined the military knowing that that they were going to essentially go to war. And that's different than when I joined in 1989. You know, my purpose was far different than that. And a lot of these sailors, maybe they joined to get a college education, but they also joined knowing that that they were going to war. So for them, I think any part that they can play was significant because they showed a high degree of courage just raising the right hand when they did and knowing the environment that they were getting into.
And, you know, Master Chief, we thank you for your service, you and everybody else who served with you. But you know, for wherever you go, from the deli to the diner, for the rest of your life, when they say you served on the USS Vinson, they're going to say, isn't that the ship where bin Laden's body was brought? You know that.
Brian, that question has been asked a lot, and it's been brought up a lot, and I think we've come to expect it. I'm really proud of the people that I serve with because it's a tough position every single time they're asked that question. But I think they're doing really well with it, and I think we've been very well prepared by our chain of command for that also. So, you know, it's a question that we anticipate, and I'm sure they'll keep coming for a long time.
And as we saw your family picture and saw the ship pull in, on June 15th, as we just said, video, you realize the sacrifice the family makes as well as those who serve because they have to make life has to go on without you. And that is never easy. And now that you're back, I can imagine the reunion makes it even more special.